Welcome, space enthusiasts, to the heart-pounding journey of life, the sci-fi thriller that takes us on a wild ride from Mars to the International Space Station. If you're ready for the cosmic suspense, hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, leave a comment below, and let's dive into the gripping narrative. Our story begins as the Pilgrim 7 space probe returns from Mars with a potential game-changer, a soil sample that could contain signs of extraterrestrial life. But hold on tight, as the probe faces a harrowing encounter in an asteroid field, leaving it severely damaged. The six-member ISS crew capture a crippled spacecraft returning from Mars. But hold on tight, as the narrative takes an unexpected turn when exobiologist Hugh Derry revives a dormant cell from the soil sample. This dormant cell transforms into the enigmatic entity that American school children affectionately name Calvin. However, the cosmic euphoria takes a dark twist after an atmospheric accident in the lab. Calvin, the once dormant organism, becomes hostile. Hugh attempts to revive Calvin with mild electric shocks, triggering a nightmarish chain of events. Calvin, now unleashed, attacks Hugh, crushing his hand in a relentless display of extraterrestrial power. As Hugh lies unconscious, Calvin seizes the opportunity, using the very tool meant for its revival to escape its confinement. The lab becomes a battleground as Calvin devours a lab rat, absorbing its essence and growing in size. Engineer Rory Adams, valiant and unsuspecting, enters the scene to rescue Hugh. But fate takes a sinister turn as Calvin latches onto Rory's leg, leading to a desperate attempt by physician David Jordan to contain the extraterrestrial threat. The struggle intensifies, and Rory's efforts with a flamethrower prove futile. Calvin, relentless, enters Rory's mouth, devouring him from the inside and emerging even larger. In a daring escape, Calvin slips through a fire control vent, leaving the crew to grapple with the horrifying reality. Hugh theorizes that the lack of breathable air on Mars might have kept Calvin dormant, unleashing an unforeseen terror upon the ISS. The stakes are high, and the crew faces an extraterrestrial adversary unlike any other. If you're hooked on this thrilling space saga, hit like, share your thoughts in the comments, and stay tuned as we navigate through the unknown together. Until the next cosmic chapter, keep your eyes on the stars and your curiosity alive. Finding their communication with Earth cut off due to overheating of the communication systems, Mission Commander Ekaterina Golovkina performs a spacewalk to fix the overheating. Calvin, having breached the cooling systems, attacks her outside the ISS and ruptures her spacesuit's coolant system in the process, causing toxic liquid to fill her helmet. She struggles to get back into ISS, but eventually realizes that Calvin will also be able to re-enter the space station. She refuses to open the airlock to seek help, and stops David from doing so as well, keeping Calvin out of the station, but also causing her to drown in her spacesuit and her body to drift away into space. Calvin attempts to enter the station through the thrusters. The crew try to use the thrusters to prevent Calvin from entering these openings, but their attempts fail and the station loses too much fuel. The ISS enters a decaying orbit, which will eventually cause the station to burn up in Earth's atmosphere. Pilot Sho Murakami informs the crew that they need to use the remaining fuel to get back into a safe orbit, but the attempt would allow Calvin back into the station. The crew then plan to make Calvin dormant by sealing themselves into one module and venting the atmosphere from the rest of the station. When Hugh enters cardiac arrest, the crew realize that Calvin was feeding off Hugh's leg. Having grown into a larger tentacle creature, Calvin attacks the remainder of the crew. Sho seals himself in a sleeping pod as Calvin attempts to crack the glass and console him. David and the quarantine officer Miranda North use Hugh's corpse as bait to lure Calvin away from Sho and trap it in a module to deprive it of oxygen. Having received a distress call prior to the damage to the ISS communication system, Earth sends the Soyuz capsule as a fail-safe plan to push the station into deep space. The capsule docks with the station and starts pushing it into deep space. Believing the situation to be a rescue mission, Sho leaves his pod and rushes to board the arriving ship, forcing open the capsule's hatch. Once he does that, Calvin attacks him and the Soyuz crew. The encounter causes a docking breach that results in the capsule detaching and crashing into the ISS, killing Sho and the Soyuz pilots. David and Miranda, the only survivors, now realize that the incident has again caused them to enter a decaying orbit. Aware that Calvin could survive re-entry, David recalls two escape pods, planning to lure Calvin into one pod and pilot it into deep space, allowing Miranda to escape to Earth in the other pod. David leads Calvin into his pod and launches into space as Miranda launches hers. One of the pods hits debris and is knocked off course. Calvin attacks David as he struggles to send his pod into deep space. The pods then separate. The Earthbound pod performs a controlled re-entry and lands in the ocean near a boat with two Vietnamese fishermen. As they approach and look inside the pod, it is revealed to be that of David, who is encased in a web-like substance. Meanwhile, due to damage sustained from hitting the debris, Miranda's navigation system malfunctions and fails, and she can only scream helplessly as her pod is sent hurtling into deep space, taking her to a lonely and inevitable death. David, still alive, tries to warn the unwitting fishermen not to attempt a rescue. The fishermen open the pod door as two other fishing boats arrive.